Now, we've heard a lot about the COVID effect on tourist hotspots like Queenstown and Rotorua, but it's important to remember the great wee towns tucked away around New Zealand too, where locals are also having to pivot and think outside of the box.
Or down south in Twizel, where they're thinking inside the ice cream parlour. Rachel Parkin explains.
You might say Sharon Blanchard's got it pretty sweet.
Voila! Ice cream in winter is a thing.
Sweet Moose is hers, and she gets to live here.
When people ask me where am I from, I tell them I'm from Twizel.
Mm-hmm. And then you're a convert.
I know, right? You wake up in the morning and you're like, I'm in the best place in the entire world.
But like the entire world, Sharon's adapting to COVID life. Lockdown left its mark.
We lost the revenue that we needed to really keep us going through winter.
Then it was sayonara tourists.
And the Japanese ski team. They come every year. They're like our best buddies.
Thankfully, one day at lunch with this guy.
Really appreciated you and your husband coming in just for a chat.
And the light bulb just kind of went on for me. Decided, you know, beautiful big space. What can I do to give back to community? So what is an IncuHub? Where people can come cross-pollinate, just, you know, incubating ideas, providing things like resume support, looking for a job.
So instead of soothing taste buds, Sharon and her helpers ease minds and give support.
It's been good to have, you know, like a second mum, definitely a second mum.
Hunter Smith, a Sweet Moose regular, now a part of Hub Furniture.
I'm here for the hugs, not
that's
the ice cream.
That's me, all about the hugs.
Before I was working as a helicopter ground crew in the office. Loved the job. Tourism just had to.
And then COVID came.
Yeah. Aww. So hopefully things do start picking back up again and maybe I'll be able to get hired again. But yeah, we'll see how it goes.
If anyone's listening.
Yeah.
Carl French pops in too.
We're a salmon cafe just outside. About 200 tonnes of salmon each year, but just for the local market.
The hub is for all sorts.
People who need a job need to pay the bills, so that's very challenging. People who are losing their jobs and applying for jobs and not getting the jobs that they really want to get.
Sharon's background in leadership and advice, the perfect blend.
You know, some people say my Sweet Moose business is really a counselling business. Come in and support and love and hug, and that's
kind of... Ice cream does make you feel good.
Right? That's my philosophy. My research is all love and leadership.
There is one challenge with the Sweet Moose makeover, though.
So what was the first thing that you said when we drove in here?
Ice cream!
The ice cream machine's out today.
And a couple of marshmallows.
Just for filming.
We've had some tears and it just breaks my heart,
yeah.
Right? And so when they come in and they realise that there isn't any ice cream, we have to have them walk away with something.
They call this unicorn bacon. How good is that?
But whether it's ice cream, candy, COVID council or cuddles, Sharon's got it covered.
It's a space where you can come, you can feel valued.
And leave cup and tum well and truly full.
Sweet, sorted. Thanks for coming.